3 freeway maps for train spotting.
Hi guys, welcome to today's episode of On Track with James and Jade. And today we're going to show you how to use OpenRailwayMap, Google Maps, and the photographer's Ephemeris, and how to use them in improving your train spotting.
Let's start with OpenRailwayMap. So what is OpenRailwayMap? OpenRailwayMap is a detailed online map of the world's railway infrastructure. It's based on the OpenStreetMap data. Let's hop in now and take a look. Okay, so we're gonna open up Google, and I've already got it saved because I went to the website earlier. You will type in Open Railway Map and it'll open up the results. It should be the first result, www.openrailwaymap.org. Once you open the screen, there'll be a drop-down menu where you can select your language. Obviously, I'm going to choose English. There's a section here where you can get more info on the online app, their blog, or to contact them or donate some money. There's a search bar. We'll come back to that just now. Below the search bar, you can select the map style, which is infrastructure, maximum speeds, signaling, electrification. But for now, we're going to use infrastructure. Below the map style is a legend, which shows us the various symbols that will be used in our search on the map here on the right, which is on the main screen. The big part of the screen on the right is the map for your main reference. Depending on your internet settings, it should open near your location. Let's jump right in. So at the search bar, type in your area of interest. For today's video, we're going to use Potchefstroom in South Africa, in the Northwest Province. I'm typing it in and I press enter. Right, so for our result, we get Potchefstroom Station. I'll left click on it. The map calibrates to your search and what you've clicked on. And here we can see on the main screen, the map will update to show the general area like a normal map, with the exception that the railway lines are highlighted. According to our legend on the left, the main line is in orange and the spurs are in this brown color. Zooming out gives us a better picture of the railway network. To zoom in or out, use the mouse wheel or the buttons on the top left. Left clicking and dragging the mouse will move the map around. Release the left mouse button to stop dragging the map around. The app color codes the lines according to the type, but it's not always accurate at depicting lines in use. As you can see, this is a great app for seeing the extent of a line and surrounding lines. Open Railway Map gives us a great overall picture and idea of the railway network, particularly in areas we are unfamiliar with. In our example, Potchefstroom is a junction, and for today's video, we are not going the length of the line, but looking for a specific spot to take photos. So we're just going to drag it along and see. And this bridge crossing Moy River looks good to us. Let's investigate further using Google Maps. Over to you, Jimmy.
Right, now we are going to use Google Maps to find a good photographic location in the area that Jade mentioned. We're going to go through to Google and we're going to open up Google Maps. I'm not going to speak about how Google Maps work because we all use Google Maps. We're going to go through to Potchefstroom. We're going to go to that area that Jade mentioned, which is the bridge above Moy River, or Moy River in English. Here we go. We got the location. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on the satellite layer. This just gives me a good indication of what the terrain is like. What I'm going to be looking for is there actually a river there? From this, we can't really see too much, but we can see a whole lot of vegetation there. And most importantly, we can see some opening there as well as the railway bridge there. So that's a good indication. Next, I would like to go through to the street side view. So I'm going to hold down there and we get this little pop-up here. I'm going to click on it and that gives me a street view of the area. And I'm just going to rotate it around to there. There's the railway bridge. I'm just going to move a bit closer just to get a better idea. There we go. Great. One of the things that's important to remember is that a lot of the images taken in here could have been taken several years before. So just do a quick little search to see when this was taken. I can see there this was taken last year. The scene should pretty much be the same as in this image here. From this, I can see there's ample parking spaces as well as just a very good general area to take shots in. With that in mind, we now need to plot what the sun will be like on the day of our photography. Right, for plotting our sunlight and the direction of the sunlight, we're now going to use the photographer's Ephemeris. For the sake of this video, we will be using the desktop version. However, there is a mobile version. For the photographer's Ephemeris, you will need to create an account. However, it is free. In my case, I've already made an account and I'm going to log right in. Now, I have pre-set it at our location for this. However, when you do open it, it should open to your location currently. The layout is very similar to that of OpenRailwayMap as well as Google Maps. So I will not explain too much about dragging the mouse. However, what I will talk about here is the general layout at the top. So on our top left here, we can see our date today. If I click there in the middle, it's going to take us to this exact moment in time. Next, you're going to see on the map is almost like a compass, and that is your sunlight. So on the right here, you got a light yellow line. That is the direction of the sun at sunrise. This smaller orange line here, that is the direction of the sunlight currently. And this thick orange line to the left here, that is the direction of the sun at sunset. These two lower lines here at the bottom, I wouldn't worry too much about, but that is to do with your civil and nautical twilight. So for the sake of this video, we're going to be working in that small little wedge right over there. Now that I have put our pin there, I'm going to just simply click on the pin and I'm going to drag it to roughly the location where I want to take the video. For your use over here, you'll see these few little arrows here, that's for your full screen. That is to take you to your current location, and this is just to middle your primary pin. In this case, I'm going to drag it to where we want to take the shot. We want to take the photograph sometime in the morning, roughly 9 or 10 o'clock. And as I drag this little blue pin at the bottom here, you can see the time changing. And as I drag it to the right, you can see the arrow or the line at the top slowly moving from right to left. Now, the great thing about photographing in August, the light will be fine throughout the day. So for the sake of our video, we're going to use roughly 11 a.m. and there is the direction of our sun. So for the shot here, as we can see, it'll mostly be a side-on shot with side-on lighting. Unfortunately, what it does not provide is the weather details of the day. So that will be to your discretion. And that is the photographer's Ephemeris, a great use of lighting. So there you have it. Those were our web apps that we used to help us prepare for a day of railway photography.
Let us know in the comments below what you thought and what do you do when you prepare for your day of railway photography. And if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe to see more of this content. The signals that proceed.
Platform is clear.
You may depart.